Hello everyone and welcome to NAC Graphics. We are discussing the topic of artboard and it's the third lesson on it. And here we will discuss about the artboard panel. Many of the functions about the artboards that we have discussed so far in the last two lessons can be performed through Artboard Panel 2, which you can get by going to Windows menu and there you click at Artboards. In this panel, you will see the list of all the artboards which are there on the canvas. Like we have four artboards here and they are listed here in a serial order. Notice that Illustrator gives an automatic serial number along with an automatic generated name. The serial number appears on the upper left corner of the artboard. Along with that, there is an automatically generated name. In the artboard panel, leftmost column is the serial number. The center column is the name. And the third column has the artboard editing button, which will open the artboard editing dialog box for that respective artboard. Let's take a look on the functions that can be performed through artboard panel. Single click on serial number column or the name column will select that particular artboard. Like I clicked on the number 2 and that artboard is active now. Clicking twice on serial number column or the name column will not only select that particular artboard but also zoom it to fit to screen like this. You can select multiple artboards only in the artboard panel. Shift key is pressed to make continuous selection and control key is used to make specific selections, just like a normal selection function we perform in Windows. Even when we select the multiple artboards in the artboard panel, practically only one artboard is shown selected in the main screen. This is so because we can perform only a couple of functions with multiple artboards selected. Firstly, we can delete selected multiple artboards by pressing the delete button, which is appearing in the lower right corner of the panel. You can also delete them by picking and dropping them on the delete button, like this. Secondly, we can move the selected artboards up or down to change the serial number of the selected artboards. And yes, I know you didn't get this point properly. We are going to perform an exercise in a while where you will have a clear idea of what I am trying to explain here. Moving ahead, along with the delete button, there is a new artboard button. And it will create a new artboard similar to the previously selected artboard. On the upper right corner, there are two buttons. This button will nudge back this panel like this. Next to that, there is a panel options button. Now let's see what it has got for us. The first thing is a new artboard for creating a new artboard similar to the selected artboard. Second is the duplicate artboard for creating an exact duplicate of the selected artboard along with the contents. Third is delete artboards for deleting the selected artboard. The fourth is delete empty artboards, and this is for deleting the artboards which have no content therein. The fifth is convert to artboard, and I will explain that in a while. Sixth is artboard options, to open up the artboard editing options dialog box in respect to the selected artboard, like this. And we have already discussed it. The seventh option is rearrange artboards, and I will explain that in a while. Okay, enough with the blah blah lessons. Let me show you a practical illustration, which will definitely give you a better understanding of this artboard panel thing. So all you need is to follow my steps. So step number one, create a new document, and don't bother about the new document options. Just select the print in the profile and number of artboards should be one only. Step 2. Set the zoom level from here to 25%. Step 3. Select the artboard tool and move the artboard to the upper left corner. Step 4. Now create duplicate copies of the artboard by pressing down the Alt key and click and drag to new place. And create two copies of it. Step 5. Come to next row and create another three duplicate copies. Don't bother about the name, but make sure the order of serial numbers appear like this. Step 6. Now shuffle the artboards by moving them. And let the 4, 5 and 6 number artboards to come up and 1, 2 and 3 goes down like this. Step 7. Now escape out of the artboard editing mode and pick blob brush from the tools panel. Go up in the control panel and choose the fill color as black from the drop down list, just in case you have the white color selected. Step 8. Now draw the numbers 1 to 6 on each of the 6 artboards by dragging the blob brush on artboards. Don't bother about how you draw, just follow the steps. Step 9. Go to the artboard tool again and one by one select all the artboards and change their name as the number they bear. For example, select the artboard on which 1 is drawn and change the name of the artboard to 1. From the name option in the control panel. Accordingly, name 1 to 6. After naming them, open the artboard panel. If you have followed exactly as I mentioned, the artboard panel content will be like this. So till now, I was trying to create an environment where you are caught in a situation where you want to change the serial number according to the name or the content of the artboard, which hereby means that artboard naming and containing 1 should have the serial number 1 and so on. So step 10, single click on artboard naming 1 to make it active and now press move up button until it comes against the serial number 1 and there you go up. Step 11. Single click on artboard naming 6 to make it active and now press move down button until it comes against the serial number 6 like this. Step 12. Now we have artboards naming 4 and 5 together and they are going to be placed against serial number 4 and 5. Here we will move them in another way. Single click on 4 and now press shift key and click on 5. Now you have 2 artboards selected. Click and hold the left mouse button to pick both of them and drag it below the artboard 3 like this. So here we are. We have not only changed the names of the artboards but also changed the serial number as desired by us. So step 13. Now say we want to keep only artboard number 1 and delete all other artboards. You can delete all the artboards one by one by manually selecting each artboard and delete them. But you can delete multiple artboards here in the artboard panel. A single click on artboard 2 and press shift and then single click on artboard 6. This will make a continuous selection from 2 to 6. So here are the 2 ways to delete this selection. Press the delete button appearing on the lower right corner. Notice that pressing delete key on the keyboard will not do the job of deleting multiple artboards because, as I already mentioned, selecting multiple artboards in the artboard panel is for limited functions, which are moving for changing the serial number and deleting, that too within the area of the artboard panel only. Second way to delete is click and hold and drag it and then drop it over the same delete button. Just in case you want to delete artboards 2, 4 and 6 only, here you will select them all by pressing the control key and delete them in either of the 2 ways I mentioned. After deleting the artboards, press control Z to undo the delete action so that we can continue our exercise with 6 artboards. Continuing with the example, we will now discuss about the option of rearrange artboards, which I left earlier in the lesson. At present, my 6 artboards are arranged in 2 rows and 3 columns and spacing between them is not even. Say we want to rearrange it as 2 columns of 3 rows with 1 inch space between each artboard. You can perform this function without switching into the artboard editing mode. Firstly, we need to understand the options relating to rearranging. Go to the artboard panel options and select the rearrange artboards This will open the Rearrange Artboards dialog box like this. The first thing here is showing the count of artboards you have. Second, we have the layout. The first option is grid by rows, which means Illustrator will arrange the artboards in rows according to the columns specified in such a way that the order of serial number flows row-wise as indicated in the icon, which is like this. As in our current case, we have 6 artboards. They are grid in 2 rows as the columns specified below are 3. And their layout is like this. The second option is grid by column, which is just the vice versa, where you specify your desired rows and the artboards will get arranged accordingly and the flow of serial number will be column wise. In our case, if we select this layout option with 3 rows specified below, then the artboards will be arranged in 3 rows, thereby making the 2 columns and the order of serial number will be like this. The next option is to arrange by row, which means Illustrator will arrange all the artboards in a single row. The fourth option is to arrange by column, which means Illustrator will arrange all the artboards in a single column. The fifth option is to change the workflow from right to left, which is most commonly used in the Middle Eastern countries. Then there is an option for spacing. Here we specify the space between the artboards. And the last, we have move artwork with artboards. Now take this option if you want to move the artwork along with the artboards while rearranging them. You can experiment with these options, and in case you want to undo the change, press Ctrl Z. Now let us perform the action where we want to rearrange it as 2 columns of 3 rows with 1 inch space between each artboard with the flow of serial number going column wise. To do this, I will select layout to be this, which is select grid by column, rows to be 3 and spacing to be 1 inch. And here is the result. And notice the order of serial number as well. Let me show you another experiment. I will just mess up the artboards terribly. Now again, go to the Rearrange Artboards dialog box. The values will be same as you said that last time. Press OK and there you go again. Everything is rearranged in a proper manner. Now we are left with only one option to be discussed, and that is convert to artboard, which is the fifth option in the artboard panel options. In simple words, this option will convert any rectangular artwork into an artboard. Perform these steps along with me to understand this properly. To create a new document with one artboard, pick the rectangle tool, drag and draw a rectangle on the canvas, not on the artboard. As you draw the rectangle, a blue border line with dots on the corner of rectangle will appear. This means that this artwork is currently selected. Now go to the artboard panel, open its options and choose convert to artboard. And you will end up converting that artwork into new artboard. You can create that artwork inside an artboard and then also it will convert the selected rectangular shape into an artboard inside that artboard in which you drew the rectangle. Okay, make yourself sure of two things before using this command. First, your artwork must be selected. If you accidentally deselect the artwork, then select it with the selection tool, which is a black arrow tool appearing on the top of the tools panel. And secondly, the artwork must be a non-rotated rectangular shape. By that, it means it should have a sharp-edged four-sided shape. There are artboard-related options in the object menu as well. Go to the object menu, click on artboards, and there you will find 4 options, which are convert to artboards, rearrange, fit to artwork bounds, and fit to selected art. And we have already discussed these things. If you are working with multiple artboards in the document, you can also use the shortcut keys to navigate through the artboards. Press Shift Page Up to jump to the previous artboard. Press Shift Page Down to jump to the next artboard. Press Ctrl Shift and Page Up to jump straight to the first artboard and Control Shift Page Down to jump to the last artboard. And you know what? Now you know every single thing about the artboard. Thanks for watching NetGraphics. You stay well.